So let's continue. Since many people were asking, you know, how the planning center works and how the whole workflow happens, and I usually like to finish always giving a next step for the ones that want to try. Right? So it's actually very simple. I showed in the morning several different possibilities, but in fact, we need to start from a simple way, okay? So for the ones that want to try the DSD workflow, the first step is Monday morning next week is to select a patient. Say, I want to try the process on this patient, right? And then just contact us and we will guide you through the whole process of documentation, submitting a case, planning, designing, markup, etc. But the process, step by step, happens like this, okay? You already saw this. So let's consider that the new patient walked into your office, okay? And now you are on the first appointment. So I showed this, the need for these supports, for these teams to work together. So this is the path, okay? First appointment, the patient walks in. And we're going to show you now, you can use the app to help you. The first reason for us to develop the app is to help implement the process. And actually, you can download the app for free and use the app to start your first case using what we call the free part of the app. Okay? And we're going to show this. But as you enter the app, you're going to click on New Case. You're going to click on patient documentation, and the app will teach your team on what type of images we need, okay? So you're going to go put the 5 pictures, you're going to do the STL, so the app will bring everything together, and then you're going to have a link to what we call the DSD Planning Center. The DSD Planning Center is based in Madrid, Spain, okay? Where our whole team is, where we have a team of designers, treatment planners, specialists, orthodontists, periodontists, prostodontists, and the director of the planning center is my brother, Dr. Francis Coachman, and he runs the team there, okay? So you're gonna document the case, and the planning center has several different products, services. We have smile design, markup, orthodontic analysis, perioanalysis, orthognathic simulation, functional analysis, many different things. But just focus on the top one that will be the first product, simple, smile design. Means you're gonna get a smile design project, you're gonna get a presentation to show to your patient, and you're gonna get a mock-up, okay? That's it. That's what we call the smile design motivational kit. So you can present to your patient next time. Of course, that as you order the smile design, we will design, send it back to you, like the same way your technician sends the wax up to you. But we will send you virtually so you can see on your device and you can evaluate. You can approve, you can ask for changes, you can communicate back and forth. So there's a chat inside the planning center website. Every case has a chat between you and our team. So you can ask for changes and everything there until the design is approved. So usually in 2 or 3 days, you get everything back to you. Okay? You can ask us to print the mock-up for you, or you can have the files and print yourself if you have a printer or if you know a lab here. The suggestion is get the files and print over here. Much faster and easier for you. But anyway, so let's pretend I documented the patient and I ordered the smile design. Another thing that I can do on the first appointment is the smile simulation in 2D for the patient on the first appointment. Okay, we're going to show this right now. And then if you do a 2D simulation, this can work as a starting point for us to do the 3D. So as you do the 2D, we can do the 3D based on your 2D. If you don't do the 2D, no problem at all, we will do everything. So don't worry, okay? So this here you see, I'm taking the photos. So I can either bring the photos from the camera roll, or I can take right there the photos from the patient. Okay, we're gonna show this. Now I'm bringing the SDL. So I scan the patient with my intraoral scanner. I export the files from the scanner and I import to the app. Okay, I create the patient information, and here you see the button. Here you see the button. Planning center right here. Here, right here. So when you click there, see all my patients are here. There we go. The full documentation of the patient is there. Videos, STLs. And then I can just click here, DSD Planning Center. And as I click DSD Planning Center, there we go. So you're gonna go to the DSD Planning Center page. And then you can scroll down all the products and the top product, DSD 3D Smile Design, okay? That's it. You see there's many things here, but don't worry. Start with the simple stuff. Smile design. Okay. So the case comes to us. We design a smile. Comes back to you. You approve. Then you can share with your team. So in between the first appointment and the second appointment, you are treatment planning the case based on this smile design. Okay, so now when you approve the case, this is what comes back, okay? The markup, the file, the presentation, and the videos showing the simulation of the treatments. So this is the package that we suggest for the dentist to present the treatment to the patient on the following appointment. So now the patient is back. So the smile file is printed, so you have the markup, and the case is treatment planned. So what you do, patient comes back, you're gonna put the markup, create what we call the wow effect, wow, before and after, and then you sit down with your patient and you present the treatment plan. Questions here? Clear? So your patient will walk in like this, and before you talk about dentistry, that's what we suggest, the first step. Before you talk about anything, the patient will walk into your office expecting a normal appointment, nothing special, and you're going to surprise them. Okay? You're going to explain to the patient that you have a beautiful plan for them, that you're going to explain this plan in details. But before we explain that, you show the 3D project and you explain the amazing technology behind your plan, and you show them the mock-up model, and you explain them that this can go back into the patient's mouth. So then they may ask, but why you want to place this in my mouth? I don't want to do anything with my smile. Let's say the patient is like, no, I'm not interested. I said, no worries. It's part of the project. We will take care of what you want. But this is simple. It goes in and out. It takes less than 3 minutes. And you're going to be able to see the project. And then we talk later. So if the patient may ask, but does that hurt? No, it's over your teeth, in and out. I don't touch your teeth. No need for nothing. How much it costs? We don't charge for that. It's part of the process. We're going to put it in your mouth. No cost. Doesn't hurt. Doesn't take time. So patients usually say, why not? And we're going to take some nice pictures and you will enjoy it. It's okay. So you click the mock-up in the mouth. It takes a minute to do that. And you take a video with the phone from before. You put it in the mouth. You take a video with the patient with the mock-up. And in 5 minutes, you present this to the patient. So the patient is like, wow, this is amazing. I didn't expect that. Explain me more. I want to learn. What is this all about? And then the conversation starts. And then, only then, you know, you're going to sit with the patient and you will explain the treatment plan. Okay? So this is the sequence. First we put the mock-up. Then we explain all the findings. And then we explain the solutions, the treatment. Okay? Very simple. So we have dental clinics from all over the world utilizing this strategy, the DSD treatment presentation strategy. You start with the mock-up, then you use technology to show all the findings and issues. Your intraoral scanner is your best partner on that as well. And then afterwards, you present the treatment plan with the DSD presentation. Now, when it comes to the mock-up, we've been doing this since 10 years. This process usually increases case acceptance from 50 to 70%. It really generates a completely different understanding from the patient, just the visual impact. Okay? So we do this every day, one patient after the other. If they step in our office, and we see that they deserve a better smile, it doesn't matter if they are asking for one or not. If we see the potential, we do it. And we give them as a gift. Even the photography. Some patients, they say, I don't know if I'm going to do the treatment, but can you give me the photo? I love the photo. Many of them, we give them the photo. Let them think. Some patients, they don't say yes, and they come back after 1 year, 2 years, and they say, now I'm ready. I remember that markup, and I want to do it. And they come back. Some patients, they don't do the treatment, but they recommend family. So I love the process. This technology is amazing. I'm not ready to do it. It's not my moment. I have other priorities, or I just really don't care about this, but I think this is amazing. I'm going to bring my mother. So it's a win-win situation from all sides. People get excited. It's fun. We have fun with the patient. We connect with the patient. We break the ice. We create a relationship. Patients really enjoy, and you can imagine why. You know, Many of these patients, they say, this is one of the best pictures I ever took of myself, smiling. And you are creating this moment. So it's extremely special. Okay? Now, when it comes to the mock-up, today we have two ways of doing the mock-up. Two ways. The mock-up is printed, but we can print. We can print the model, or we can print the shell. If we print the model, we need to print the model, do a silicone index, Bisacryl material in the mouth, clean the excess, wait 3 minutes, and remove. That's the traditional mock-up with Bisacryl. Okay, everybody understand?
Yeah.
Nowadays, recently, the printing companies developed and released printing materials that are tooth-colored. So now instead of printing the model blue and white together, we can print the teeth directly. So we don't need the model, we don't need the silicone index, we don't need Bisacryl, we don't need to wait to set, we don't need to clean the access, we don't need nothing. We jump from the design into the mouth. So we print the shell like you see on the video. That's printed. You print super fast and you click in the mouth. Okay? Both ways works perfectly. This usually takes a little longer, 5 to 10 minutes, because you have to wait to set and you clean. And this one takes 10 seconds. You take from the box and you do like this. That's it. Okay? So printing machines can do magic nowadays. They really print beautifully. The texture, the shapes, everything is really, really amazing. Okay? So the path is very easy. You can design on the app. The 2D project of the app goes to the planning center. The planning center does the 3D. The file comes back to you or to your lab, print, and goes into the mouth. Okay? So it's a fast, inexpensive, super powerful, smile, emotional experience. Okay? So we have hundreds of videos. There's people from all over the world using the app, designing smiles, and ordering the mock-up. Okay? So my suggestion, just try. Okay? Download the app and try. I mentioned about downloading the app for free. The free part of the app allows you to take the pictures and order the case from the planning center. Now, if you want to do your smile simulation yourself, then you have to purchase a couple of different packages in the app to allow you to do the cases. Okay? In the free part of the app, there's a couple of cases preset in the app that you can practice. But if you want to do it on your own patients, you can buy, I think, packages of 3 simulations. Very inexpensive. How much is it? $39, 3 cases. Yeah? Here is A, B, or C. A, B, or C. A, B, or C. A, B, or C. See? So, we're gonna, Ralph is gonna explain later. Okay? So in the app, you also have this part of the app where you can design in the app the before and after, okay? So you can make very cool, fast combinations, okay? And present. So you can make the simulation and then do the before and after, or as I usually use, I use before and after, I take a picture from before, put the mock-up in, take a picture from after, and then in the app I make these super nice filter, black and white, texture. And then if the patient gives us permission, we post on social media immediately. Okay? So this is how it comes out from the printer. These beautiful shelves. This is another example here. I'm doing a simulation to the patient. I'm doing two simulations, super fast. That's why I use the app, because it's super fast. Like this one, I'm showing crown lengthening and veneers. This one, I'm showing orthognathic surgery and veneers. Okay? So look how fast, and you show to the patient. And then here you show. So you can show both simulations. When you're explaining the treatment plan, you can show both simulations to the patient. Okay? Now, she decided she wanted to test this solution before thinking about orthognathic. Of course, this is a very aggressive surgery. So the patient's like, can I do a mock-up like this to see if it's good enough? Say yes. So this file goes to the planning center, and I order a mock-up from the planning center, okay? So this is her with the mock-up. Without, look at the shelves. We call it the shelves, okay? So this one is, it's over her gum, so simulating the crown lengthening procedure, okay? How it may look after crown lengthening. So when she saw herself with this, even though theoretically orthognathic surgery would be ideal, she saw this and said, that's good enough for me. That's a great. Crown lengthening, veneers, I'm fine. Okay? So you have the 2D simulation, you have the mock-up test drive, and then you go for the treatment. It's another case. This is the before. There we go with the app, smile design, simulations, they look really very natural. And then the simulation comes to the planning center. Now, this is in the planning center. So now we are designing the case for the dentist. Then we print. If needed, we can do a little bit of flow just to hold the shells in position. It literally takes 10 seconds. If the teeth are sticking out underneath, we can use a black marker, and you have a very nice before and after. So this is back to the other patient. This is her surgery after crown lengthening. So she did here crown lengthening and Botox, holding the lip, and she was happy. Okay? But everything because of that mock-up, okay? Another example of a mock-up. This is the design. See, not an easy case. But then we change this and we make everything bigger. Why? For the mock-up. And then that's the mock-up. A couple of tricks here. What do you see here? See the black here? So always have a black marker ready. Because if the existing teeth are longer than they should, you can use optical illusion here. And when you have black background, look, it disappears and you have the illusion. So I use a lot of black marker with my markups and also pink composite. Look, pink composite to simulate what? Orthodontics. So here, this case here, I'm selling orthodontics and veneers. So we do a lot of mock-ups to show to the patient the benefits of doing the ortho treatment. Okay? So look how nice here you have. The black marker there doesn't, you see, you cannot even see. And you have pink composite here, here, there. So the markup, pink composite, and the black marker. And you can do magic. 5-10 minutes, picture, before and after, show to the patient, wow. Then you sit down, and then you explain. That's the strategy to value. Now, another thing that is getting interesting is that these materials, these printed materials, are now approved to be used in the mouth. So if you have a printing machine, and that's why I recommend every dentist to buy a printing machine. You can start printing your own provisionals. Imagine that. Chairside. We design quickly everything. You print. The cost is super low. And you have inlays only, tabletops, veneers, crowns, anything you can print. Even prosthesis over implant. You can do a lot of cool stuff with printing. Okay? So if it's a mock-up, we don't need to glue. It's in and out, 10 minutes. Same appointment, we remove. Motivational mock-up. If it's a provisional, you can spot etch and bond. And it becomes a provisional. So before we go, into the technical part, I want to share with you a video. This video was produced by a DSD clinic in Geneva, Switzerland. From Eduardo de la Torre. It's a DSD doctor that uses our concepts of design, treatment planning, and presentation, okay? So what is the nice thing about this video? This video shows the reaction of patients looking at their mock-up for the first time. So honest, real reaction, because the patients didn't know they were being filmed, okay? So these are just normal people walking to the dentist and then getting their mock-up. You know, some of them, the smiles were not that bad. Some of them didn't want to do the treatment. Many of them didn't want to do the full treatment. You're going to see many of them need ortho. Some of them didn't want to do ortho. So normal people walking in, documenting, case presentation, and then the doctor puts the mock-up, makes the before and after, and shows to the patient. The first moment when they see their mock-up, we recorded their reaction, okay? So I want you just to show you this so you can see the impact in people's mind when they see themselves with a nice smile. It's amazing how powerful it is to see yourself with a smile that you didn't expect, okay? So let's see the... Powerful smile, huh? That's why I tell you how amazing it is to be a dentist. We can make this happen, okay? So we need to get the credits that we deserve for being able to do this, right? This is what we say. So just for you to understand, for the ones that were asking for information, okay? If you want any kind of more information, please go to digitalsmiledesign.com. Okay? Once you go there, there's a lot of information here explaining the process, etc., etc. But three important links. First one, if you want to learn more about our courses, just click on education. And we have a four-day course that we call, what we are doing here today is what we call the DST Day. But the full program is called Residency 1, 4 days. It happens always in English in either Madrid, Miami, Seattle, or São Paulo. Okay, 4 days, we cover absolutely everything, the whole program, okay? By the way, I have to mention that they asked me to mention that I will be back here to Taipei. That's what this paper says. So if the paper is saying, it's probably because I'm going to be back, right? I have to. 2019, April 27-29, the 6th annual APAID, Devil into Innovations of Implant Dentistry, right? APAID, International Congress in Taipei, April 27-29. You can see here a lot of names, some very well-known names, and I'm here, so I'll be here back, okay? It's a lecture where I'm going to be talking a little bit more from the clinical perspective, treatment planning, right? So I hope to see some of you back on that date. Okay, so let's go back here to our website, okay? So when you click here on the menu, education is the first area you can go. Then the second area, DSD Planning Center. DSD Planning Center. If you click on DSD Planning Center, this is where you come. So for whoever wants to try, you need to register here and create an account. Okay? And then you can send your first case. Okay? Easy. And everything will happen through here. Any question, please don't hesitate here. This is the most important information of the whole day, because our support team is amazing. They can answer any question, okay? Contact at digitalsmiledesign.com. Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and say, I don't remember nothing, I forgot everything, contact at digitalsmiledesign. I think I enjoyed the lecture. I don't remember. I want more information. Boom, they're going to give you everything. Okay? They're going to get in your get your hands hand by hand, side by side, and guide you through the process. By the way, taking advantage of this information as well, since we believe so much on the Asian market, we are beginning of next year opening our first office in Asia. And it's going to happen in China, and it's going to cover the whole area here. We're not going to only open an office, we're going to open a planning center where we're going to train Chinese designers, dentists, treatment planners in your own time zone, in your own language, to cover this whole area. And our new partner, director of this project in China, is here. Pepe, if you can stand up. Pepe is our new partner, and will run the whole operation here, and he has a lot of experience. He worked for many years with Invisalign, with Align technology, so he knows exactly how to bring dental products into services to serve you. That's what he was working with. And he participated, that's the reason why we connected. He participated on the last year on the collaboration while he was still with Invisalign. He was running the project between DSD and Invisalign. So he knows the whole workflow. We didn't steal him from Invisalign. He left Invisalign first and then we we took him. And it's a great pleasure and honor to have you, Pepe, in the team. Great, great person. I hope you will have time to interact with him. So not only contact at, but Pepe at, right? P-E-I-P-E-I, Pepe at Digital Smile Design, and you have somebody speaking your language that understands the whole process and is going to run the project, okay? Okay, so that's the first thing. You have to register here at the DSD Planning Center website, and then to finalize, if you want to start using the app, below Planning Center, you have the app. So if you click here, you're going to go to DSD app website, digitalsmiledesignapp.com. And then you need to do a second registration. This is very important. Two different websites with two accounts, completely different. Okay, people get very confused. Next year, they will be all merged into one. But today, for the next 6 months, you need to create two accounts, dsdplanningcenter.com to ask for the services and products, digitalsmiledesignapp.com to be able to create an account and download from App Store. If you go to App Store now, you put search DSD app, you're gonna see the app there. You're gonna download, you're gonna download. You're going to open the app, you're going to open the app, but then you're going to start to try to work and a window will open saying password, okay? So to be able to use the app, first you need to go to the app website, create an account, create a password, and after you create a password here, you go to App Store, you download the app, you open the app, and the window will come. Username, password, you put, and then the app is open, and then you don't need to go to the website anymore, okay? You can download the app on your iPad and on your phone, and that's the beauty. Why? Because everything you do on the iPad may be on your office, so you're documenting, you're doing beautiful simulations, you're doing beautiful designs, and then you leave your office and you're with your phone and you're traveling and you can access everything from here. DSD app, you click here and everything you see on the iPad at your office, you see over here. So all my cases are here. And in one click, full documentation. So I can be anywhere and I can have all my cases over there. I can open, I can see all the pictures, STLs, CBCT, periochart, x-rays, everything that you upload here in your iPad, in your office, or your assistants are uploading, you can reach here, okay? So this is, for me, one of the most powerful things about the app, that I have in my hands every single full documentation of all my patients, and if I'm with a colleague, I can show them quickly. I can open, click, share with other experts, have their opinion on the case, okay? And of course, from here, I can click Planning Center, and I can order whatever I want. Surgical guide, provisionals, tabletops, full mouth rehabilitation, perio analysis, smile design, mock-up, orthodontic simulations, everything at the tip of my fingers, okay? So my suggestion is click here, become a member, and generate an account in the app. Okay? As simple as that. Of course, you can register also with your Facebook. Okay? So let's move into the app demonstration now. Okay? Rob, can you help me here? Back to the laptop. Laptop. Go. Always show from here. Always show from here. Show the icon. Okay. And we can turn off these lights. Okay, so this is the icon here. You can see the red icon here. And if you click, you open the app. Okay, that's the way it looks. The menu is right here. Very simple to understand. At the top, you're either starting a new case or you want to access your existing cases. So as I showed, this is exactly the way I see on the phone. Okay. So if we look here, my cases, it's connected to the internet, yeah. So just for you to see, this is on the iPad. Go to the, yes, that's exactly. Look, on my phone, okay? All the cases here, exactly the same way you see right here. Okay, whatever I change here is saved here because it goes to the cloud, back to my phone, and there we go. Okay, so my cases. Since we are starting a new case, I want to start a new case. This is the home page of the app. A couple of things here, very easy. These are the five existing solutions. Okay, five existing solutions that we have. And in the end of this year, we're going to have one more here, and that's going to be the 3D design. Okay? 3D design. So, if I want to just document, I want to take the pictures and order something, the first is the key. If you click there, this is the guide to show you everything that needs to be made. If you go back to the analysis, is if you want to do all the drawings yourself. Smile simulation is what you saw if you want to do a quick before and after with the smile simulation. Smile outsource is if you want to document the case but ask for somebody to do the design for you. So it's like the Uber of Smile. Do you have Uber here? Yeah? So it's the same. It's like you document the case, and let's say you don't have the time to do the simulation. So you outsource this, and somebody from the Smile Design community will catch your case, design, send it back to you. Okay? Smile outsource. And before and after, is that those cool little tricks with putting photos side by side, three photos, four photos, video side by side, filter, black and white, texture, put your logo, draw, all these little tricks that we can do to make nice, nice pictures, okay? There's many apps that do these things, but what we did that was very interesting, we took some of the best apps to work with photography, and we took the best features of each app and we put all together in one. Because for people that work a lot with social media, for example, sometimes we need to use one, two, three different apps. One to do the filters, the other one to do the collage, the montage, to put side by side, the other one to draw. Here, everything is in the app, okay? So, let's start with the smile simulation. Where is the patient? Is the patient around? Who's the victim? Ah, okay. We need a chair, and we need lights. Let's put the patient right here. Let's put the patient right here. So the light. No, not that light. This line is okay. Yeah. Yeah, you can see. How do you turn this on? Perfect. How do we bring this up? So, what's your name? Henry. Thank you, Henry, for helping us out. I remember your face by getting your photos. No, that's fine. Now, usually we recommend the very important part to make beautiful images with an iPhone or an iPad is to have very good light. Okay? Even if the room is full of light, it's not enough. You need LED light. So your phone will take great pictures. Okay? So you can have either two tripods, two of these, perfect, one on each side, beautiful. Or what is even more simple is one with the circle. There's a beautiful LED circle that generates great light for dental photography. Okay? Since we don't have the circle, I'm going to ask you to be the second tripod. So this is a very fancy, expensive tripod. This one is made in China. No, in Hong Kong. Made in Hong Kong. Tripod. Fancy. Okay, let's go to the app. Okay, so let's pretend that Henry is a. I had a longer cable. Okay. Henry, if you can go a little bit to your left. Okay. Yes. So let's pretend Henry is a first appointment patient. Okay. So, as he's waiting for the dentist to come. Let's say I'm the assistant, and I'm going to just do a quick simulation for him just to start, creating awareness. Is this water here for a reason? Or I thought there was a reason for the water to be there.
Just for the balance.
For the balance. Okay. So I click on frontal facial. And I'm going to take the photo. Now, actually, I'm going to show you. Below take the photo, there's select frame. Select frame is a very cool feature because sometimes it's hard to take the perfect picture, to click the perfect moment. So select frame is actually going to record a video and break the video into frames, into pictures. And then every second can generate like 30 pictures. So you have dozens of pictures that you can then select the best one to make the simulation. So it's very, very useful tool. Okay? So I'm going to just take the video. And if you can look here to the camera. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to just record so I don't need to have to worry about clicking the photo because it's recording the video. And just give me a big, big smile. Stretch. Show a lot of gum. Yeah. More. Look like this. Tell him a joke. Give me like a sexy look. Come on. Yeah, it's a little better. That's not. And now I need a smile where you separate a little bit your teeth. Opening a little bit. More. Stretch now. Show your gum. Yeah. No. You can do better than that. And separate. Open more. Yeah. Now show more of the uppers. Yes. Yeah, that's good. Let's see. Let's see what we have. So why I was trying to make him open the teeth, because usually the most powerful simulations are with the teeth apart. Because when the teeth are apart, the before picture is very powerful, because with the teeth apart, we can see everything that is wrong better, and we can see everything that is beautiful better. So usually the trick here is to try to find a picture where the teeth are apart, okay? Or slightly apart. Okay. So you see how many pictures. I'm trying to find the one he's showing. More teeth. This one, this one, perfect. Imagine if I was trying to do this with photos, okay? So, there it is. All I need to do a smile simulation is the face, nothing more than that. If I want to add a video or an STL, it's fine, but I don't need. Then, you see that the app already automatically I'm putting over the eyes and clicking automatic face ball. So it automatically makes the average and does the simulation, the rotation of the picture for the simulation. You can, Aaron, if you want to sit there and watch, you can sit from there. Yeah? It better? Okay. Yeah, better than I sit here. I wanted your chair, that's why I wanted to. You too. He's gonna come back for the mock-up, but for now it's okay. Then, next step, and I want you to see how easy this is, okay? The app is just asking for a few references, okay? So we're gonna make some references here. App is asking for a measurement. I don't have, I'm gonna guess, but just the app is asking, what is the real measurement from here to here? And then let's say it's 16.5, for example. But now comes the design, okay? Doesn't give zoom here. And then, first thing I want to do is to set the smile frame. So the drawings are, here we go. So here you need to practice your smile design skills. This is the length of the central. This is the proportion of the central. Okay, if I'm happy with this, I can come here, select any shape, and the shapes will automatically fit into the frame. So super fast. I can have my smile donators. We can select some models here with natural teeth. Every tooth here is natural, okay? Every tooth here is natural. Maybe I can put this teeth. Where is Henry? You want to try my teeth, Henry? Or her teeth, maybe. Very important. There's no male shape and female shape. Every male shape can fit women and men. Every female can fit men and women. There's no sex on the teeth. So it's all about the shape. If you like the shape, no problem at all. Okay? So let's see here, a nice... this one, for example. Let's try this. Perfect. Now, let's design. The line is so thin. Oh, this is something, Ralph. For people that present the app, to have a button to double the thickness of the lines for lectures. It's a nice feature for teachers because everybody... So now it's tooth by tooth. I need to start. I can move. I can rotate. Move down. I can widen. Rotate a little bit more. Lengthen. Now the canine. Too wide. I'm going to make it narrower. Rotate. And the molar. Can you see a little bit there, Ralph? Is it possible to see? Ralph, can you see?
The molar?
No, the teeth in general. The lines.
Yeah, yeah.
Lateral. Canine. Bicuspid. And molar. Okay, if we are happy with this, now the software is asking us to outline the upper lip so we can slide the teeth behind it. Perfect. And now many different colors here. Don't worry if the colors are not matching, because now I can play with the colors. Brightness, blur is always important, saturation, a little bit of warmth. Then I can fix the gum if I want. So this is, it's like a piece of, look, like a little piece of gum. That if the patient somehow you want to show how gum surgeries or ortho or crown lengthening or artificial pink or orthognathic surgery or dentures. That's good. Finalize, and that's it. Good. Oh, there's one trick here that is nice. Oops. Here, stump color, and we need to be able to zoom more. Stump color means that I can take the color from one place. So for example, now, from the tongue, and I can paste. So if the teeth are longer, I can remove that. I can even use this to shape the lowers. Look, if the lowers are not straight. And you can so finalize. Now the lowers are straight. Look at the lowers here, lowers there. And then this. There's no, you could bleach the lowers as well. If I click here, there's not much of the lowers here, but I could bleach the lowers if he was showing more. Okay, apply, done. Now, I can add the logo of my office, I can let my name, I can share. For example, immediately with the patient. Where's Henry? Put your email here. It's gonna go to you so you can show your girlfriend. Your wife, okay. Put your email there. Done. And bye-bye. And then here, to save the case, Ralph?
Arrow.
And? Okay, here we go. If I want, I can make measurements. Okay. For example, if I want to make notes. So now, let's say Henry's already gone home and Henry's gonna come in 3 days to listen to his treatment plan. So I have to send this to my lab, okay? Henry, if you're gonna sit back there. Thank you very much. Thank you. Are you a dentist as well, Henry? Are you a dentist? You're not a dentist. You're just a friend helping us out. Thank you very much. Log value, so whatever we want to measure, we can measure, okay, in the app. We can also draw. The images are neat. No? Oh, no? So this is also very useful, okay? You can make any comments to us, the lab, right? You can. You can make some nice mustache here. Help him out here. Let's help him. a little bit more here. Make a nice glass. Good. You like it? Cool. Yeah. And apply. So this is going to the lab. If we want to add notes, you can add notes here. And everything we add here becomes a presentation. This is going to become a slide presentation automatically. So every layer, every note becomes a slide with the information. Okay? So you can add as many notes that you wish. And you can write. Okay? And you can move the notes. So to comment, whatever. So as I open, I see the notes. And then we can proceed with more analysis, or we can just save the case. So Henry, like this, Taipei. No patient number. We can add any kind of information. Cool guy, nice guy. And we can go to the planning center. Okay, so this is your assistant. Patient is gone. Your assistant is putting the information together. We can add more files. So let's say we did an intraoral scan. We did the rest of the photography. So now I'm filling up the whole with any kind of information I want. The more, the better. 5 pictures, 1 video, and the STL is the minimum. But if you have more info, just share the info, okay? So now I just click next, and there we go, the planning center, okay? This is Madrid, this is us. And then you can go over everything, whatever you want. Quick explanation. TSD3D is the entrance, is the most common, is what I suggest you to try first. Functional is the same, but with upper and lower waxer. So if you know that you're going to need also the design of the lowers, you can go straight to the second one, upper and lower. Usually only with the upper is enough for you to plan, make the markup, sell the case. And then you, whatever is needed after case acceptance, you order afterwards. So you don't need to take the risk of investing on something before the patient says yes. Because we don't know. In 3 days, he's going to come back. We don't know. So the minimum package is the top one. Okay, the top. 3D complete interdisciplinary is if the dentist wants us to simulate all the possible solutions, implants, ortho, crown lengthening, perio, orthognathic, whatever is needed, restorative, bite change, function, everything, okay? Invisalign collaboration is for the ones that already know that it's going to be a restorative Invisalign case, and there's a complete different pathway, but let's start easy. Just try a case with the first. You add, you go next. If you want to add something else, no, just go simple. This is important. This last page is asking, do you want just the file or you want us to manufacture? Okay? So if you click nothing here, you're going to get all the files and you're going to have to print. Okay? Either the model or the shell. Where's the shell? Here we go. The shell. Okay? So let's say I want also to print the upper model and I want to print the shell.
Christian, you have to select this additional service. Yeah. Design.
Here we go. Here. Yeah. Here we go. Design of the shell and manufacturer of the shell. And that's my order. Order. And it's going to order. Okay? I shouldn't have done this. But then I'm going to lose the case now. Okay. Continue and save, right? Patient info. So let's say I did order. Now I close. I don't know what I did. Maybe I lost the case. See, we dentists, we're too fast with your fingers. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. So let's pretend this order went to Madrid. 2 days, I got everything back. I printed everything, and now I need your help again. And let's go back now to the camera. Here we go. This is mine or yours? This is yours. Okay, so light. Okay, and does this work? Yeah. So, you can have a seat. You can have a seat. So, in 1 or 2 days, you get a notification. Ready, case ready for your approval. You go open, you open the case, you check the design, you ask for changes, you approve, back and forth, 1, 2, 3 modifications, 2 days, 3 days, ready, the files come, and you have everything done, okay? So what comes to me? So what, I'm gonna get an email saying, the case is ready. Let's see if I have an example here. It's the planning. Here we go. You have received a new message regarding your case, blah, 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 blah. Always by number. So we don't mention the names of patients online, right? And then I can go to the website, I can log in to check my case. So this is the page, I'm entering my account, and I can do this through the app as well. So always through the desktop on the website or through the app on the mobile device. And we have here all my cases. So as I open my case, you see the chat. I'm talking in Spanish here, and I'm asking the case, asking some details of the case. This is all the information of the case. And every case has 3 windows here. The info of the patient, the files you, the dentist sent, so here we go. This is what the dentist sent, okay? And this is the files that you received. The presentation and all STLs, open STLs. So everything comes here. This can be the STL of the restoration, surgical guide, implant guide, orthognathic splint, ortho aligners, everything comes here. Mock-ups, provisionals, whatever file we designed for the dentist comes here. And in blue is the presentation. Most important here, because we want to present the case, so downloading there. Okay? So I'm going to show the presentation, but let's show the box here. So once you order the whole thing, let's activate the camera here. If you So this is what it comes. If we manufacture for you, you're going to get a box like this. And inside the box, remember I ordered the model and the shell. Okay? So if we order the model, this is what comes. Let me put my gloves. Gloves. So let's say you got this morning, the patient is coming in the afternoon, so we want to check. The model comes like this. So you have the, zoom in a little bit. This is the model with the design. Look at the texture, look at the shapes, beautiful. Look at the wax, you can see here the wax up over the teeth. Okay, this is the motivational design. It's covering the gum, and it comes with this tray. So here, if you want, you put the Bizarcru here and in the mouth. Beautiful. Okay, so that's an option. Now comes our new exciting product. Super cool. Is the shell. So the nice thing about the shell is that, of course, it's much easier to place in the mouth. So the shell comes like this. It comes divided in three pieces. Usually, to allow for path of insertion. Let me take the pieces out here. One. The fit is so good. That is even hard to take it out. I don't want to break it. Okay, there we go. So what you have here is the pre-op model. See? Beautiful quality as well. You see there's always the name so we don't get confused. Because sometimes dentists does the silicone index over the pre-op, then the mock-up is not going to look good, right? But what I want you to really pay attention here is the shell, is the quality of this shell. Let's see here the texture now. It's like blurry, a little blurry. It's too bright. Bring the brightness down, yes. Look at the texture. Printing technology is really, really amazing, okay? Beautiful shape, super delicate. We can print 0. Nothing, super thin, okay? Three pieces, perfect. Fitting on the model very, very well, so I know this is going to fit in the mouth. And then all I want to do now is just check presentation is still 10 minutes, okay. Let me see if it's somewhere else here. Taipei, see if you see Taipei. Patient Taipei, who is this? Oh, this was my other course here. I was here before. You know that? Still downloading. Sorry. Anyway, let's put the... So the PowerPoint is downloaded, so you sometimes it takes 10, 20 minutes depending on the internet. So make sure you download this before your patient comes because you want to have everything prepared. But let's start with the mock-up and then we go and we show the presentation. Okay? So let's bring this back here. Cameraman. Oh, let's record a video of the before. Video. And then we need the other light. Wait a second. The other light. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, Henry, now you're going to have to remember your old days as top model and just give me some, you know, some big smile. And Rocky, help me make him laugh. Say something. Ciao, Jean, Jean. Cachin, Jean. Zam, Zam. You didn't understand me? Okay. Big. You're gonna show. What you wanna do is record some nice angles. Yes. That's right, like that. Like that was good. Show you. Yes. Now the other side. And go from here. And ha ha. Ha ha ha. Super funny. Pretend I'm funny. Ha ha ha. Big. Okay, bring the light up. Yes, good, you do it. Okay, that's good enough. One more, ugly. No, okay, that's fine, okay. So, now, composite, a little bit of composite, since usually I want the patient to be able to stand up with the mock-up. So, what I suggest you to do, we have a flow ball. And then the light is here. Okay. And the flow is here. A1 is fine. Huh? So I put one little drop. There's the tip. Of flow just to create some retention so the patient can actually have fun a little bit with the marker, okay? And so there we go, here, film here. Oh, let me try first. You can put forward like this. And we have here and here, very easy. You just put. And the fit is perfect, okay? There we go, like this. Okay, so we come here. Here. Show here. I'm going to put a drop. Interproximally here. Just to create retention. Enough to stay in position. And then we come with the light. And a little bit here. Good enough. Now I go here. This is good. Doesn't even need. I don't believe it needs composite. It's staying. And here. It's also staying pretty well. Bring forward your head. Stand up a little bit. And now, usually when I have the pictures of the after pictures, I usually like to make them standing up. Because when the patient is standing up, he can actually relax a little bit and be more casual and give me some better, cooler images. You can have it the light here. Now big, now I want a big smile. Oh. Oh. It's a little bigger than before. It's bringing out, yeah. So this is important. You see that it doesn't matter how nice the mock-up looks, patient will always feel like it's too big. Usually because it is too big, but even if it's not too big, anything in the mouth feels super big. So two things you need to understand. Don't worry about what they say now, and don't give them the mirror. If you give them the mirror first, you destroy the whole moment. Okay? Because when you grab the mirror, what happens? You activate your rational side of the brain. You deactivate the emotional side of the brain. And you bring the mirror and you're going to analyze your mock-up rationally. You're going to do like this, you're going to do like that. You will never get those reactions, the nice reactions I show. It's not that we're going to hide the truth. We're not hiding the truth. We can give the mirror later. But the first impact will be made by a beautiful before and after picture. So what you need to do, put the mock-up, the patient is curious, patient doesn't know how he's looking. He has a feeling that he's not looking nice. So you need to find a way to create a nice video, select a nice picture from the video, side by side, and create a beautiful picture. Show to the patient. He's going to be amazingly surprised. When he becomes amazingly surprised, then he relaxes. And then you can make even nicer videos. So I suggest two videos. One to create an initial nice photo, and a second one for him to give you even better. And then afterwards, when you're explaining the treatment, you can even give the mirror so they can see the limitations of the markup, because the limitations of the markup will also help you explain the treatment plan later. For example, telling him that he needs ortho to bring the teeth back, otherwise it's going to look too bulky, things like this, okay? So now, Henry, I need you to relax. Camera always above. This, we're going to have this, right? Come here. Yeah. Cool. Is it recording? Recording, big smile, top model, come on. You're looking good, man. You want to see? Are you curious? You need to turn faster. They always do that. I always do this with the patients. So let's do one. Me and you. Come on, selfie. Okay, go. This is going to my Instagram. Okay, Are you okay becoming famous in Brazil? Are you fine? Okay, let me. Okay. Yeah, big smile, big smile. A big one. In Brazil, we like to smile. You have to give a, oh, you're looking there. So yeah, okay, look at the smile. Zoom in, zoom in, zoom in here, zoom in the super. Bring this light back closer. Yeah. Ha! Yes, look at the cat. You see, he's looking here. That's why he's not giving me a nice smile. So, what is the best smile? The best smile is when you're slightly leaning forward and you're giving a smile with the teeth slightly apart. So when you do like this, that's when you see the smile. Okay? Let's try it together. One, two, three. Look. Like Colgate. You know Colgate toothpaste? Every Colgate commercial, everybody in the Colgate commercial is super happy, right? Smiling. And everybody's smiling with the teeth apart. Colgate. Why? Because when you smile with the teeth apart, you see the beauty of the teeth because the black background is showing that, right? So where you, I think he gave me a Colgate smile. Let's try now. Ha! Yeah? Try, look, he's, I think we got it. Let me see. So now, what we do here. Whoosh. Okay. This is... So what I want to do now, this can turn off. Henry, if you want to have a seat again, it's fine. And that's why I like to do the videos, okay? Because in the video, there's many good photos. What's going on? There we go. This is a great photo. So I'm doing a print screen. And we play the video. All right. That's a good one as well. So now, in the office, what happens? The assistant is taking the markup out, or you're taking the markup out, and your assistant, whoever is faster with technology, is doing these print screens, and I'm gonna build a couple of nice before and afters, okay? So I have 2-3 minutes, maybe you can give a little coffee or a tea to the patient, ask him to wait for 3 minutes, and you are playing. Uh-huh. That's a cool photo. Henry is a timid guy, right? He's a shy guy. That's why the video, because if you have a camera, it's 10 times more difficult to click on the perfect moment that, and the key here, the trick to make a beautiful picture of somebody is to capture a moment that the patient is smiling with their eyes. So this is very difficult to capture on the photography, okay? So that's why with the video, we can move and we can find a moment where he was giving an honest smile. This can be another one. That's a good one, right? But he gave a real smile here. Yes, one moment. That's a real smile. Look. Oops. two of us take one like this. Let's see the other video. I tried. You see, here, look at this image. The smile is nice. The smile is nice, but his eyes are not smiling. So this is a picture that will not make him connect. Okay? So the key is to find the moment the patient is smiling with the eyes. So I don't know, you know, jokes in Chinese. Otherwise I would tell him a joke in Chinese. This is a real smile, look. This is a real smile. So we want to capture these moments. This is a good one. This is a real smile. This is another one. So a bunch of pictures. This is him saying, I'm tired. I'm done. Okay. Now, if I go here to the pre-op, because now I want to take some pictures from before. This is a good one to compare, right? Of course that he has beautiful, very nice natural teeth, so he's probably maybe bleaching and aligners max, right? So we are trying to make something up for the course. But let's compare. Let's take a picture from this side. Yes. That shows a lot. Looks like he was in pain. Maybe this one is more natural. Then a final one from this side. Okay. So now I have a bunch of pictures. And I just need to go back to the app and then use my tool here, before, after layout. So let's get one from before. Let's get one from after. And now you can build as many and say, I can do some filters. Different filters if I want. If I don't want, I just take this. And then I can do another one. And let's take it from one side now. Let's take it from this side. And let's take it from and save. Now from the other side. So you can build as many smiles as you wish. Let's put this side here. It doesn't. Yeah, this needs to give freedom here. Raw. It doesn't give me freedom too. Zoom, but it doesn't help. Yeah. Edit, crop. So, that's good. So let's bring the picture again. Need freedom here. Yes? We need freedom. And now video. Gonna make a side-by-side video. So I'm gonna grab the before moments. Which one he was stretching more? And here, what I wanna do is, I wanna find the moments of the video where he shows more his smile. Okay, preparing the video. And bring the video to the app. Let's zoom in. And And now let's put the after. Use. If it's framing good. And now we merge. So now it's merging both videos together. Close and share. Now I'm just gonna grab the one I like the most here. Actually, we didn't take this picture. I like this one. And I usually take the best picture and I make it black and white because it looks very cool. Black and white makes the picture look more sophisticated. Which one is better, this, this, or this? This one. This is also good, huh? This or this? Color, black and white. Color, who prefers color? Color. Nice, huh? Black and white, who prefers black and white? Okay, so we do both. Done. And then we edit black and white. And now, very easy, we can now bring the patient from his coffee, sit down with the patient and put some nice music and show him the presentation. We can start from here. Okay, so here it's the best thing is to pick 10, 20 seconds from before, 20 seconds from after, so the patient can see the interaction here with his big smile. And then where's Henry? It's a nice smile. Another one. That's actually a good picture. Yeah, he said he's not an actor, but he looks like a model here. Nice haircut. I'm gonna make this a nice picture. Your wife is gonna like this one. I'm gonna crop here to remove me. And I'm gonna make it again. Done. Then we see this. Not bad, eh? This. The video we already saw. This is the one I'm gonna post on my Instagram to make him famous in Brazil. You're gonna have a fan club in Brazil. Your wife is not gonna like that much. Black and white. And the cool picture here. Okay? So now, when we are done with this presentation, hopefully the patient will be enjoying. And what we need to do is now to explain the treatment possibilities. So this is what comes with the presentation, okay? So that's the second step of the treatment plan presentation. This comes also. So the first thing you're going to find here is a list, a report that we're going to make notes of whatever we found important. Okay, constricted buccal corridor, altered occlusal planes, crowded anterior teeth, uneven gingival margins, anesthetic existing prosthetic treatment. So this is to help you organize. This is what we found, so to add to what you found. So here are some important images that we do to help you plan the case. Okay, so we have frontal occlusal. Images, these images with the lines are usually interesting to explain to the patient. Look here, for example, it's very easy to explain to the patient why a soft tissue graft here, connective tissue graft, would be interesting. Not only to protect the roots, but for aesthetic reason. Okay, here is in, here it's above. So these lines are very, very helpful. Okay? This is the initial design. All different views. You see, we have a simulation of the connective tissue graft there. And a little gingivoplasty here on the centrals as well. So what we see here, here a little bit, so a little there, so their centrals are even. Very useful presentation. You can see the where the gum is missing. The transparency always very powerful. So you see here, his teeth here, here, and here, his original teeth are longer than the design. So we are suggesting what? A little bit of intrusion here, here, and there. Okay? So you see exactly there. So it's very useful for treatment planning. Proportion of the central, 76% is pretty good. The lower, I always love this image with the lower without the upper, so we can see that his arch with the face. You can see how the arch is off with the face, okay? The crowding, then you see the lower design, and you see the lower design trying to fix the inclination of his arch. There we go. Full functional design, lower design. So you can see the tooth movement required. So the design helps a lot with the whole planning, okay? This is very important, overbite, overjet. So you can see the new design. Somebody was asking, you were asking me, who was asking? I think the guys from Vietnam. About how much we can lengthen the centrals. This is the image that helps you, okay? On his case, his face is not asking the centrals to be longer. He already has a lot of exposure. So the wax up is not making his central longer, which shows that there's no functional interference here, okay? If I would make this longer, I could see here exactly how much of stress I would generate, okay? So this overbite, overjet analysis is very important. This is the mock-up. And here you can even have some slides if you want to do before and after side by side. Now, I always order functional simulations. So every time I send a case, I don't want to think what needs to be done. I just want to tell the planning center that whatever they find interesting, they send me a message, I approve, and they simulate. So if the patient needs implants, the simulation and the presentation comes with the implants. If it needs crown lengthening or bite change or ortho, everything comes as part of the process. Now, this is a very important slide. Mm-hmm. This slide shows what we suggest. Blue teeth, we suggest ortho and restorative. Green is only ortho. Purple is ortho plus crown lengthening. Red is only prosto. Nothing ortho crown lengthening on the dark purple. So this is a very nice image to help the dentist to explain the treatment to the patient. And this is also an image that goes to Invisalign team. So the ClinCheck team technicians, they get this as well. It's another communication. And then comes here the best part, because I get a video. So it's like having the software here in front of me to present to my patient. Now the most important is this. This is the great difference. This is the reason why Invisalign is working with us. Because what you see here in blue is the facially driven ideal design. And then what happens is that now we can move the teeth inside the wax up. So the whole ortho movement is guided by the face and by the design, okay? So look, before and after. Very nice ortho case. Beautiful before and after. If I was him, I would definitely use aligners and do this. Look from occlusion, look where we are and where we can be. Very nice, from the 12 o'clock, and then before and after. And then the best is that we can see in the face. Look. This is very nice. So you can put on the face before and after. Before and after. So you can show this to your patient before and after. Bring the Lord. And these are the restorations. So this is before ortho or after ortho, before ortho, after ortho, and with the restorations. Some images to help show to the patient. After ortho, the restoration design, and then a report of suggestions of treatment. So we are suggesting, of course, this is a suggestion, the dentist is the one in charge. You need to use this as just an additive information. You need to treatment plan the case. So from what we saw, of course, we didn't do the clinical exam, we don't have his perio chart, there's many things that we don't have. So from our design perspective, we suggest orthodontic treatment on both arches in order to expand arches, expand buccal corridor, level and align all anterior teeth, slowly extrude the 12 and 22 and 23 to bring down the gingival margins, and prepare for final prosto treatment. About 12 to 18 months ortho treatment. So it gives a nice vision for the dentist. After ortho, gingivoplasty, a little bit of crown lengthening, if necessary, after ortho. In prosto treatment, 4 anteriors on the upper and 6 anteriors on the lower. This is the suggested plan. This is to show you the shell. This is the file of the shell. And this is the presentation. Okay? So, you put the mock-up and you present the treatment. Put the mock-up, present the treatment, okay? So, see all these slides, really a very comprehensive presentation, okay? So you have these two powerful tools, this and this. Okay? So I'll be definitely open for questions for whoever wants to get more information. Me, Ralph, Pepe, we will be here. We still have, I think, half an hour before we have to run to the airport. But I wanted to, again, first of all, thank the whole team for the invitation. Gloria, Ricky, my moderator, thank you very much. And if you can help me to thank our patient Henry for coming and helping us, and a hand of applause to Henry for helping. I hope he enjoyed his new smile. And yes, I'm open for questions. And thank you all. Thank you all for coming. Thank you very much. See you next time. See you in maybe.